Now the barrel comes off really quickly. It's got this little gripper here that kind of grips against this barrel nut. If you push that guy in and start twisting on this barrel nut, it comes off really quick and very easily your barrel is out. So if you wanted to chuck this in a backpack to go shoot some squirrels or something like that, again, this is non-restricted with this length barrel on it, so it's very easy to do that. I'm just gonna throw the rifle to the side there. Here's our barrel with barrel shroud on it. And you can imagine, I could take the barrel shroud off. It's that diameter all the way around, so it's quite skinny. And I think this barrel shroud does a good job of, let's be honest, making this thing look a lot cooler, because with this long skinny barrel, it looks a little bit weird. Now that said, the short barrel is available, so if you want to run this gun here in Canada as a restricted, you can, but you won't be able to take it out to gravel pits and that kind of thing. I think that will limit some of its usefulness, so I don't mind the idea of this long barrel, but again, it really depends what you want to use this thing for. If you really love this gun as a really cool, the closest to an Uzi you can get in Canada, maybe you do have to run the short barrel. Now, while I've got the barrel off, why don't I show you guys the guts of this beast. So I'm gonna grip the disassembly guys here with both fingers, because they're on both sides, push it forward. That lets me snap this dust cover up and off. Very easy to pull off. And you get to see the guts of this beast. Look at this big old bolt. There's a lot of weight just kind of coming back and forth, right? I really like the idea of what's going on back here. I don't know how well you can see that, but this is very AR-180B. I did a review on an AR-180B, and it's very similar to this. Dual guide rods, dual springs on the back here, and to disassemble, you just kind of pop them out the top. So there go our, there's our recoil action right there. Very easy to throw that out of the way. I don't know if you can see this big bad hammer down at the bottom. Very, very wide, big hammer on the bottom. Very interesting. So there's our bolt, and it, can it come out the top like that? That would be funny. There we go. Yeah, there's our bolt. Look at this big bad piece of metal right here. So there's our bolt, and very interesting design to it. Very robust. If you want to talk about robustness, you can see that all these screws here have been peened in so that they're not going anywhere. They're staked very well. We've also got a couple of, looks like blind pins or blind screws that have been ground off and staked as well. So some interesting attention to detail in this machine pistol. Just while we have it open here, I don't know if this is interesting to any of you, but here's the wonderful guts of this BRS 99. So you can see that it's very simple. We've got our fixed extractor ejector there. We've got our hammer, and we've got this sleeve for our barrel that's kind of sitting right there, and then another one right here. So a very simple internal mechanism on this thing, not really much going on, but that's kind of good, because you know, you want something like this to be simple and reliable. Got to put it back together. It's just a matter of dropping our bolt in there. There we go. And grabbing our recoil springs. Oh boy, can I do this one-handed on camera? Yeah, get in there. Go to your home. Okay, there's our recoil springs. Boom, easy. So I mean, not really much to that. Like that's pretty much it in terms of operating mechanism, right? We've got this dust cover on here, and as long as I make sure it is straight going on, push those two guys forward, pop it down. It is on there nice and securely. And then let's fold that guy down, grab our barrel. The barrel's got a couple of dog ears that just kind of sit on there, and the dog ears kind of face up and match up with the barrel. You can see those really easily there. And we're just gonna kind of, you know, scooch it in there. I could lock the bolt to the rear here to make it a little bit easier for myself, but who needs that? Push that little guy in there while we're twisting the bolt, barrel nut, and it's tight. So very quick to get this thing cleaned up and back in action.